Now, let's join Paul in action.
Let me give you six ideas. And there are six values that I truly believe that we gain as we give. And that's one thing I'll say this afternoon. We're all in the business of giving because we're all in the business of people. This very first value when we start talking about giving in people is what I call the value of endurance. I look at a quote, and this quote came from Ralph Waldo Emerson, and I've always liked this quote, and it's very simple. It's quoted, "What lies behind us and what lies before us are tiny matters compared to what lies within us." As volunteers here today, as individuals who are responsible for people in our community, you have to have that endurance. You do. You know, there's always going to be times when people are discouraged. Yet when these individuals are discouraged, we have the chance through our leadership to teach endurance. You know, the mayor referred to a book. I was privileged to write a book a number of years ago. I'll never forget my first book signing at Barnes & Noble in Tulsa, Oklahoma. I walked in. There were 30 chairs set up because I was going to say a few words that evening. I sat down with two stacks of books. 3 hours later, there were still two stacks of books and 30 chairs empty. And I just sat there and I thought, wow, why am I doing this? You have to ask yourself at times, why am I doing this? And why do I choose to give to people? You have that answer. You know why you give to people. This second value is one of my favorite. I call it the value of optimism. You know, when we talk about attitude in volunteering, what an opportunity we have to encourage people to be optimistic. I'll give you an example. Have you ever been around someone who's negative? Now think about that. I'm sure everyone's looking around, and I'm sure you could say, oh yeah, Paul, about every other day. Okay, fair enough. When you're around someone who's negative, what does that do to you? Okay, someone just said it makes you negative. You bet it does. Have you ever been around someone who's positive? Well, naturally you have. After you want to slap them a couple times, what do they do to you? Okay, here's where I stand on attitude, and I mean this extremely sincerely. If you're going to be positive, then be positive. If you're going to be negative, then be negative. Just be consistent. That's all I ask. And people look at me and they say, Paul, you can't say that. You're a professional speaker. You're not supposed to talk about this. Stop for a minute. There will always be those individuals who choose to be negative. And they will never change their attitude until they choose to do it. However, with that said, I've always believed it takes more energy to find the negative in something than it does to find the positive. I'm a big believer in positive energy. Because when we talk about optimism, every day when we walk into a room, we bring in a tone, we set a tone, we bring in energy. As a professional speaker, I've got to tell you, it's a lot of fun. However, here's my challenge. I talk about having a positive attitude. I talk about leading by example. I have one problem. If I'm going to talk about it, then I've got to live it. And there are days I don't wake up like this. There are days I'm not real happy. There's people who look at me and they say, you're always like this. Oh, most days I am, but there's some days you don't want to deal with me. We all know that feeling. So when we talk about the value of endurance and the value of optimism, these are ideas, but don't we learn through volunteering the importance of these two values?